Hi guys, it's Julie from cookedbyjulie.com. Today we're making creamy roasted chicken legs. This is keto friendly and low carb, but it's so delicious and it's definitely a rich and comfort meal. So let's hurry and get started. I'm using bone-in chicken legs. You may certainly use boneless chicken, but do keep in mind that boneless chicken cooks a lot quicker than bone-in. I just drizzled some oil all over the chicken that's going to help give some color to the chicken and also help the spices adhere to the chicken. So yeah, just make sure to coat the chicken with the oil, and you want to use an oven-safe skillet. I season the chicken with paprika, oregano, cumin, granulated garlic, salt, and pepper. The exact recipe will be over on my website, cookedbyjulie.com. Make sure to sign up to my free newsletter on my website so you receive every single recipe I make that I don't share on YouTube. I actually posted this recipe on my website about a month ago, just so you get an idea how my website works. Okay, so I combine all of the spices together. Make sure to season the chicken all over, under the skin as well. And you can even refrigerate this overnight if you'd like, but it's definitely not necessary. Let's roast the chicken in a preheated oven at 400 degrees for 20 minutes, and then you want to flip it over and cook it for an additional 20 minutes. So total, you're cooking the chicken in the oven for 40 minutes. So this is the same skillet I used to cook the chicken in, obviously, right? You want to remove the chicken, set it aside. You can leave the chicken drippings or clean it, but I highly suggest leaving it. I went ahead and added some onions. I sauteed them over medium-low heat for about 3 to 4 minutes. I then added some fresh garlic and some red chili flakes, but that is optional. I added some tomato paste. Do not omit the paste. It gives a lot of flavor, and you just want to cook that for an additional 30 to 40 seconds. I added some white wine. Make sure it's not fruity, but you may omit the wine if you'd like and just add some chicken stock instead. Once you let the wine reduce by half, you want to add some tomato sauce. We want the sauce to be very flavorful. We do have a lot of things going on here, but it really works. Trust. Go ahead and add the cream. Season the sauce with salt and pepper. Taste it and let it thicken a bit before adding the chicken back to the skillet. I cooked the chicken and the sauce for about 10 minutes, so total the chicken cooked for about 50 minutes. You can add spinach and mushrooms if you'd like. You can add anything you'd like, but I kept it very simple. You can serve this with cauliflower rice if you're following a low-carb diet. If not, white fluffy rice works, mashed potatoes, whatever you like. This was so flavorful and a very quick meal, in my opinion. Definitely give it a try. Let me know if you do, and I want to thank you guys so much for watching.